We have a top cover design here with a couple of indents. The indents are not simple extrudes, but rather they blend from the top face into a recess. Let's take a look at how this can be created. We will begin with a simple extruded cut using this sketch. We now need to create a surface that blends from this edge to this edge. This looks like a job for the surface loft. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Loft. Check on the Chain Selection option. Select this chain of edges as the starting profile. Select this edge as the ending profile. For rails, click on the selection arrow and select this edge. To achieve a smooth blend to the top face of the cover, we need curvature continuity here. Click on Profile 1. Set the Continuity option to Curvature. And select Align to Surface. So now, we have created the surface that we need. However, there is a void underneath this surface. How do we fill up this void? A typical workflow is to create a few more surface bodies surrounding this void. Stitch them together and fill in the void. In this case, there is actually a pretty handy command to fill this in one step. Go to Create, Boundary Fill. Select both the solid and the surface bodies as tools. The command analyzes the geometry and identifies a potential void that can be filled in. Click on the select box for selecting cells, and check on this cell that represents the solid formed by filling in the void. We also want to check on the cell for the main body. This produces a copy of the main body. For operation, set to new body. By doing this, the new void body will join with a copy of the main body to form a new merged body. Since we do not need the original main body and the surface body, check on the Remove Tools option